So this was that junkyard dog cooling unit. I pulled it out of the cabinet and pressure washed it. Got a fresh coating of paint. And I changed back to what I think is the original style fan blade. A lot quieter. The new two-speed fan capacitor is inside this box, mounted on the unused fan motor bracket on the compressor body. As you can see, low speed is working. Now, somebody had asked what constitutes servicing a cooling unit like this, and I guess that would depend on who you ask, and it would depend on what it needs. But in my opinion, if you want to make one of these reliable, you should always change the starting components. In the case of this one, it's capacitor start, so it has a brand new start capacitor. Put a brand new overload in there, thermal protector overload. And this one had the original start relay, which is, on these early ones, it is serviceable. It can be taken apart. And I cleaned it in the ultrasonic, and the contact points have probably 60 or 70% life left, so put that back. The condenser fan motor has an oil wick inside here, and this one actually has an oil port, that screw. So I put some 20 weight electric motor oil in there. And then to keep the refrigeration system healthy, this filter dryer is new. This didn't come with a filter dryer, it just had a screen. So I installed that and a support bracket for it. Installed a standard quarter inch SAE Schrader flare port for servicing. 100% new wiring, new power cord, compressor lead from the box, and the four core cable up here to the fan motor. Also, the thermostat, it's a Ranco, and I cleaned it in the ultrasonic internally, and verified that the contacts were still good. It has probably, again, 60 or 70% life left. And then the fan motor in there, disassembled it and lubricated the oil wicks, made sure that it didn't have any bearing wear. So, in my opinion, that's what I do when I say I've serviced one of these. And I've been doing them this way for, man, it's hard to remember, more than 10 years. And if the compressor checks out good when you start and you service it like this, haven't had any trouble. They just keep right on going. So I'm going to grab the thermostat here and turn it up and start it up and let you listen to the startup sound. The evaporator fan makes more noise than the compressor starting, I think. And of course, on top of that, we got the proudly made in the United States of America logo embossed into the steel. Hope everybody had a good Easter Sunday. I did. Catch you later.